Welcome back, everyone. Let's dig more into the promises, because the question on the promises are like favorite for everyone. So we have seen the basic promises and how to write the promise code. So they may ask you to write the basic chunk of code and how we are resolving and rejecting the promise. So it's like in ES6, we can create a promise object. Before ES6, there was no way to write a promises. We need to use some other libraries like a promise library, queue library in Angular 1.x. But now we can write this plain promises with the ES6. And here we will be either resolving it or rejecting it. So this is actually promise object. Now, after that, we just need to check that it is resolved or rejected. So we used to do that using p.then. So p.then. Here we need to specify the function, okay? Either we will be getting the data or either we will be getting the rejection from that promise. So here you can capture data. This is all about the basic thing. Let's talk about the writing the promise for simple API. So wherever we are firing actually data, firing a call and trying to get the data from that, and there we will be using promise. So here we are passing the URL. So what we will do, we will return the promise object from here. Autocomplete is not working. Function, it will have a resolve and reject. I can use arrow function here. Okay, here you need to fire in an HTTP call. So like if I'm using jQuery or something, then I can write a code something like this, $.get.json. So there will be some different, get.json may be some method, and I'm passing the URL. When it is done, means the operation is over, I will be just passing the success callback. Here I will get the JSON data. So here I can say that you got the JSON data, then I can resolve it with the data. Otherwise, if you fail, so there are two methods, and here you will get the failure callback, and here you may get the error data. So after getting that, you can just reject this promise. So there are a lot of concepts in this, like promise chaining is there. You can just do a chaining of promises after returning the resolve from one promise. So like this is the function I created, and I wanted to fire a call to the multiple URLs. There can be a scenario where you have the different URL one. So I'm trying to have a two key value pair here. So this is object, either you can have a key value pair or I can just have a single array. So I wanted to fire a call onto that. So let's do a promise object. So here I'm trying to give you one scenario where if you wanted to fire a call, fire promises on a multiple URLs, and how can you do that? And we already have a function which is doing that. So I'm just running a map operation on that array. Okay. And then here I can use promise.all. So there is a way using which you can fire a call to all the asynchronous calls together. So here promise.all is there. You can do the promise chaining. So once all these are resolved, then I will get the result. And this result will obviously be an array Okay, item promise dot then I got the results, then you just need to run for each or whatever you wanted to do. I will just do the iterator on that. And if you wanted to do just a console.log, if you wanted to just print them, just do the for each. So it's like we are getting the data. So similarly, I created a one promise here. So once that is resolved, so you can also do the chaining of the promises, like let me explain you. So this is the promise object I have. So this is the function actually, fetch JSON. And what I'm doing, so let's consider this is another example. There can be another method fetch JSON 1, 2. Okay, so if fetch JSON 1 is resolved, so actually this is returning a promise. This is returning a promise. So what I can do dot then here I will see if the promise object is resolved, then I will get that. So you can I can do the chaining here. Once this is done, okay, fire so if this is promise is resolved, then I can fire this another method. So this way you can do the chaining. Now when you do dot then, because this particular promise block is another again returning a promise object, so I need to wait for until the promise is resolved. So similarly, you can call another method here which may be returning promise, then you can just do the chaining here using dot then. So this is called promise chaining, and it helps us whenever we need to have these kind of scenarios. So there are a lot of questions can be raised about the promise. What is a promise resolution? What is promise rejection? How we can resolve all the promise together to run all of them parallel, which we did it in like this, promise.all. So I think that's it. So many questions we have covered on the promises.